Well, hi again, you guys. Welcome to another edition of Curtis Collects Vinyl Records. We were down in Nashville last week, and we went for a very brief visit, and we saw some really cool things. And we got to see a show at the Grand Ole Opry in their new location. They still have performances at the old Ryman Auditorium, or the Ryman Theater, in downtown Nashville, but this is kind of by the convention center. We were staying, and apparently when you get your tickets, you kind of get them in advance, and whatever show is, you get six, seven, maybe eight or nine artists performing for that night, and the show moves quickly. It's recorded live, and there's an MC, and it's broadcast worldwide on various radio outlets, so it's really cool to get to go. And then we did the backstage tour, which was really incredible to see the behind the scenes of the Grand Ole Opry. So I got to thinking about some of my country and western albums, of which I have a lot. My favorite band in that genre is Alabama. So we're going to play a song from, I think this is their second, well, probably their sixth album, but they really kind of had a few albums before they really made it big. We'll go through the records that I have by Alabama, and we'll get back to this one. I'm not sure what order we have these in. This is great. This has Tennessee River on it. What a great song. My Home's in Alabama. And they kind of hung it up and they retired, and now I think they have a new record out. The first time they've had one out in 10 years. This is called Mountain Music. And this is one of my favorites. It's kind of hokey. 40-hour week. It's got some great songs on it. Can't Keep a Good Man Down. Down on Longboat Key. Some other great things on there. And then this is Roll On. That's a great title track. One of my favorite songs to listen to while driving. Really cool. So we're going to play a song on this record, which I'm not sure if it has a name. It's just Alabama. Huge slow song on here called Feel So Right, and I also like Love in the First Degree. But we're going to play See the Embers, Feel the Flame. It's one of my favorites that they do, so we'll get that going. Thank you. like that song a lot. That's kind of that's the sweet spot for me for Alabama. They got a lot of great songs to choose from, like 45 or 6 number one songs on the country charts. That song, See the Embers, Feel the Flame, was written by Jeff Cook. And apparently the words and the lyrics, these guys were talented. They did a lot of songs that other people wrote, but Randy Owen, Teddy Gentry, they all seem to have sort of a nice mix of songs that their own that they wrote and performed, and then they weren't afraid to do songs that were great songs that fit their style that were written by others. And in Nashville, it's not hard to find talented songwriters. Wow. If you look up some videos and you see Jeff Cook, I'm going to tell you, every video he's got a different guitar. It's really cool. That guy is a guitar guy. He's great. He's one of my favorites, and boy, does he have guitars. Speaking of guitars, we went to a guitar store in Nashville, and we also went to a record store, but the guitar store we went to was called Carter Vintage Guitars. It's unbelievable. As the name implies, vintage guitar, so they have a lot of high quality, very high quality, used guitars, and some of the greats in the music business stop in there, unannounced, to shop and browse and look for guitars. You wouldn't be surprised to see, I'll think of his name in a minute, but apparently right after we left, Don McLean walked in. So we missed him, my wife's favorite singer-songwriter. Vince Gill probably is a known customer there, so really cool. You can see their website and a lot of pictures of the great guitars there and some videos too. So this was another edition of Curtis Collects Vinyl Records. Thanks for watching, thanks for listening. Commenting down below, appreciate that, and subscribing. See you guys next time. Thanks again.